Salutations, Proboscis 2 here, here to showcase yet another collectible I will hopefully be implementing throughout Dark Souls with a Yellow Sponge. This time we have the Blue Mini Kits from LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. Now, the Blue Mini Kits are pretty self-explanatory. You just hit the Blue Mini Kit at the beginning of the level, then you'll have 10 minutes to hunt down and kill 5 prostitutes hidden throughout the level, so here's one.
What does a girl have to do to get laid
made lines for them, or imported them from GTA, but anyways. Hopefully you can hear that right now. I don't have my volume up for my monitor. But, yeah. There. That's one. Now let's gotta go find the other 4. Trying to remember where I hid them. So there are triggers around them that when you enter, it triggers a line for them. That's how you know when they're near. Okay. I think there's one in the Chocolate Creek. Oh, I almost forgot to mention. I made a code to transform into the sponge ball. Oh, wait. Yeah, there we go. And... this is not good. Do that. I press down on the D-pad to get out of bounds. Well, it sends the out of bounds event to the player when you press down on the D-pad. That's not part of the code. The only thing the action replay code does is you press right on the D-pad to switch to the sponge ball, and left on the D-pad to switch back to the player character, and I'm using Minecraft Freak 73's mod to change to SpongeBob and Patrick by pressing up. But... so, yeah, I can do this, that. And when you press left while you're playing as SpongeBob, and if he's moving, you kind of have to spam it to make him get out of the sponge ball. But anyways, let's try killing some more prostitutes. Isn't killing prostitutes fun?
Call the police!
Oh, wait, I forgot the one down. Here.
Ooh, I love to have a good time.
It's a little gory. I think people in the community can handle it, hopefully. Hopefully I don't have to censor this video or anything. That'd be a shame. Because I worked really hard on those bits of the body. I don't want to change to the sponge ball. You saw earlier, the sponge ball can glide across goo, or in this case, chocolate. Yeah, I know where she is. Aha. Oh, that's... There's one either here. No, it was an extra. I'll get that anyways. What the? Well, not this. Wait a minute. Huh, that's strange. That happens when, you go into an out of bounds trigger as a sponge ball. When you spawn back as a player, and I guess it only works when they walk on Sims, they'll do this. Not sure how to fix that, but. Maybe I'll come up with a solution sometime. Anyways, let's get a good view of this. Should have disabled this. Anyways.
Around here.
Oh, this one's floating. I wonder. Can you... yeah, there you go.
I'm feeling like
Got her.
Already.
One more.
Upsy daisy.
Damn it. Switch to SpongeBob after pressing right on the D-pad to change to SpongeBob. Not sure why. Hopefully this stuff isn't Sims. Yeah, it is. Whatever, I'll just fly. Ow. Bit my tongue.
Been a while since you had one of those, hadn't it?
I just felt like doing that. Huh, I guess I missed one somewhere, because, gosh, I'm trying to remember where that other one is. Oh, I remember where it is now. It's back this way. Yeah. This is a tricky one. I made this challenge with the knowledge that I would be using the moon jump code. So, yeah. I know where it is. Let's play SpongeBob. Here. There she is. And bam. There we go. We won the challenge. So yeah, that is the Blue Mini Kit challenges in the SpongeBob movie game. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.
Tip.